Yeah, happy. Thought it was a difficult game for us today. I thought, especially that first half, the first 25 minutes, 30 minutes, I thought Manchester started better than us and made it very difficult for us. Very hard to find those lines of passing, but I thought the last 10, 15 minutes of the half, we came into it a lot more and a bit more belief, but I just felt that it was going to make a tactical change in the second half. So I gave it 5-10 minutes. They scored the goal and made the change at that point, and I think that really allowed us to come back into the game. And yeah, no, obviously it's great when that happens, but I think it was the right thing to do, and it did. It freed us up and made us look much more of a threat, which was important. And there was times where we were going to have to defend, but I thought we scored the goals at great times, and they were good finishes as well. I think ultimately we had the best chances in the game, and there wasn't too many chances from either side, but when we did get the chances, we were very clinical, which is pleasing.
Gary, how satisfying is it when a tactical switch comes off like that, especially against the manager's experience as Louis van Gaal?
Yeah, of course it is. And I think at that point they didn't quite cope with that change and they didn't react to it well, which gave us that period where we scored the two goals to be able to, you know, take advantage of that change. And then I think from that point onwards, we defended very well when we had to, and we defended our box. We made another little tactical change towards the end with the long balls to Fellaini, and I think we saw the game out well. But what was the most pleasing was the character, the passion that the players showed today. And we've played some amazing football this season already, but I think we showed the other side as well. And that's the part of being a good team, is to be able to adapt in certain situations when you're not playing so well with the ball and against a very good side. And we showed that very well today.
For
85 minutes.
That's what he said.
It's a long time, 85 minutes, isn't it? But no, I think first half you have to give them credit. I thought we're playing against a very good side here, and I thought they dominated the ball. They didn't create too much, to be honest with you, but they were very dominant, like you said. They made it very hard for us in pressing us and passing those, stopping those passes, lines of pass. But second half, I thought we did very well. I thought we were well in the game, and at the end of the day, we had the best chances in the game. I don't really remember them having too many chances. So we've played in games where we've dominated for 85 minutes, and we've played in games like today where we haven't dominated for 85 minutes, but we've come away winners, and that's the most important bit. Of course it is, and 3 points, and I don't think anyone can really grumble with that result in terms of the way that we applied ourselves, organised ourselves, and dealt with the difficult moments. But then when we had our chances, we were clinical today, which was very pleasing.
Yeah, great pass
and a good time run from Baffy, and Andre has that. We try and use, obviously he's a threat goal wise, but he obviously has a good range of passing as well as a lot of the other players, so we practice that a lot in training, trying to utilise that side of it. And I thought it was a fantastic goal and came at a good time again. Like I said, I don't think they really adapted at that point to our tactical change, and we got two good goals. And from that point, I think we defended pretty comfortably. I can't really remember. The only time they really looked a threat was when Rooney went through, but Ash recovered excellent, and what a great tackle that was. That's worth a goal in itself. So apart from that, I don't really remember them really, really hurting us after that.
3 wins out of 3 against United, Gaz, for you. I mean, how big an achievement is that for this club and for you?
It's 9 points, Gaz. But no, of course it is. It's excellent. The thing for me is that we've done the 3 games on merit, I feel. You know, I feel that we won those games on merit. We took our chances well today. This was probably the hardest game out of the 3 games to win. But I thought we dealt well without playing so well first half, and second half, I thought it was a very even game and very open, but our change allowed us to win the game. So we have to be very happy, of course we do. And we go into the international break unbeaten, very confident. Hopefully the international players come back in good health, and we can go again when we pick up against Watford.
It's been quite a start to the season, hasn't it? All told, this first little landmark in the season. You couldn't have asked for a lot more.
No, not at all. But I think I'm very happy with this group. I think we're a good team. The bottom line is we're a good team, and I said to the players that we've been produce our best football, and then we win games. And if we can't produce our best football, we make sure we're organised and disciplined, and we do the right jobs. And you saw that today. Everyone was very clear in what they had to do. So, we can go as far as we want to go, but it's going to take a lot of hard work. But the group work in a fantastic way. You can see today the commitment from them and the work rate that they have, and understanding of what they need to do. So, we continue to do that, and hopefully we have an exciting season.
Are you hoping that Jonjo Shelvey gets an England call? How much did he doubt that he'd get that call?
Well, I think he's done enough. You look at English midfielders. It depends what Roy wants to play. You know, I can't say what type of midfielders he would like, you know, but I don't think anyone's done as much as Jonjo in midfield. I think you look at Jack Cork as well. The two of them in midfield area, there's not many doing those jobs that they're doing to a better level. So, you know, if they get in there, they'll deserve it, put it that way. But if they won't, they'll continue to work hard, keep trying to make it hard to not be called into that squad. And hopefully they are this time round. If not, they'll keep working.
Jonjo's had a brilliant start to the season.
Yeah. Well, I think he said it himself. It's time to grow up, you know, and he's done that. And, you know, I spoke to him, have a good relationship with Jonjo, and work closely with him, and he's worked very hard. You know, he's worked very hard at the end of last season. He's come back in a good way. He's much fitter. He's looking stronger. He's not quite there yet, but he will be there if he continues to work and play how he is. And you forget how young he is, you know, he's so young still, but it's time to grow up. He said that himself, and I think he's doing that. I think he's doing that in a good way.
Gary, how do you assess EU's overall contribution? I mean, obviously he's made a goal today, scored a goal, but defensively he's put in a pretty good shift as well.
Yeah, that's what you want from your players, to be able to do everything. But we work on that daily. We work on, with and without the ball, how we play, how we set up, what we do in certain moments, if we're doing well, if we're not, and we're able to adapt very quickly. And that's what a good team should do, and if you're a manager, that's what you want your teams to do, and so you have to work very hard with it. But the way the group are, you saw the work ethic today, their commitment to the work that I do with them, they understand that they need to do it, and it's showing in the results. We have a very good squad, so it's exciting. You know, I'm excited to be part of it. That's the bottom line, and hopefully we can take this momentum that we have and take it into the rest of the season.
What's the situation with Montero?
Yeah, unfortunately, Jeff pulled up in training yesterday. Just a bit of soreness in the quad area. Had a scan. There was nothing clinical, so that's good. Good news. We were re-scanning him just to make sure, but in a few days' time. But it was more soreness and tightness. So, you know, Jeff's a very explosive player, so you've got to be very careful in situations like that. So, decided it was best that we didn't involve him today and risk him being out for a long period.
And stories today that United might go for Baffy before the transfer deadline. What do you make of
that? No, the squad will be the squad that we go forward with. I think you saw today how committed they all are and how excited they are to be here and go forward this season. And I said all along, you know, this squad is the one that I want to take forward for the season. And I'm very, very sure that will be the way it is.